Thank you, Brian. Well, it is now time for our first live guest of the show. With only 5 days until the solar eclipse, many people are preparing to be outside to view the event.
And since this is rare, we are speaking with a local eye care specialist about how we can all be viewing this eclipse safely.
Yeah, let's say good morning to Dr. Adelie Thompson, an ophthalmologist with Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist. Good morning, Dr. Thompson. Thanks for being with us this morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
So we've been told as we were kids never to look directly at the sun, but do you think maybe an eclipse would give you maybe a break from that since it's shaded behind the moon? Why is that not true?
So I think that's really why there's so much concern about staring at the sun during an eclipse. The sun's not brighter during an eclipse, it's just that more people are tempted to stare at it because for a brief minute or so, the sun will be partially or at some point completely occluded, so it's safe to look at it just during that part where it's completely covered, but then you're probably going to risk damaging your eyes during the part where the eclipse is moving up over the sun, and then you might be staring right at the sun. And staring right at the sun can damage the retina, which is like the photo paper of the eye, the photo paper that sends all the signals to your brain so that you can see. And the damage that happens to your eye if you stare directly at the sun is irreversible and can cause blindness. So you could be left with a permanent blind spot in the middle of your vision if you stare directly at the sun, whether it's on a regular day or a day when there's an eclipse.
And even though North Carolina won't have full totality, those dangers you mentioned still could be a problem for a lot of people, right?
Absolutely. Looking at the sun directly is always dangerous. So those sun rays can really burn the retina and cause that permanent damage that we don't have any treatments to reverse it. So it's really important not to stare directly at the sun, whether it's during an eclipse or during a partial eclipse, and no matter where you are.
So what can we do, Dr. Thompson, to keep our eyes safe, everyone who wants to be able to look up at that eclipse?
Absolutely. I mean, there are safe ways of viewing an eclipse. It's important to make sure you buy some proper solar eclipse glasses or an approved handheld solar eclipse viewer to protect your eyes. And these actually have to meet certain criteria. There's an international organization for standardization that actually is the filter has to meet certain criteria for that, ISO 123122. So you should see that number on the filter. And when you're looking for approved glasses, it's important to also make sure that they're from an approved vendor, somebody that's been vetted by the American Astronomical Society. And if you get those glasses in the mail, or you want to make sure you check them and make sure there's not any damage to the actual filter, because if there is damage, that could still cause those rays to be able to penetrate through.
Dr.
And
Thompson,
other things that are, yeah,
please
just
continue,
to make sure
I'm sorry.
You're not assuming that you can look at the eclipse through like your camera or your telephone or binoculars or a telescope, because if you're staring at the eclipse through those, the rays are going to be even brighter because they're going to get focused by the lens that's in those. So you don't want to stare at an eclipse unless you're wearing protective solar eclipse glasses. And you don't want to use your camera, even if you're wearing solar eclipse glasses, because the rays are going to be able to burn and penetrate through those filters that are in the glasses.
Good to know.
Yeah. It really is, and you bring up a lot of really good points, Dr. Thompson. I recently did shop for glasses myself, but there's, you go on some of these big box retailers online, and anyone can put that, ISO logo on their glasses. What is the safest way to get these glasses that you can wear and not have to worry about getting eye damage?
Yes, that's an important point, and you don't want to go cheap here, and you want to make sure you have an approved vendor. So the American Astronomical Society actually publishes a list of approved vendors of eclipse glasses and viewers. And so they have vetted the companies that create these glasses and made sure that they're actually meeting those standards and that they're providing a quality pair of glasses or a quality eclipse viewer.
American Astronomical Association.
Mm-hmm.
You said, okay. That's good. I need to take that down and look that up. I also was thinking like your local eye doctor maybe offering them. Have you heard that at all?
Yeah, and your eye doctor may be offering them. And I think depending on where you live, in some states, like some libraries may be offering them. But I would want to know like where those glasses were procured from, because they may not be aware of the vendors.
Yeah. Well, it was really great to hear from you, Dr. Thompson. Thank you for this helpful information. And for everyone at home, we'll post this segment later on triadcw.com in case you missed anything.